It's good to have your company today. We're going to begin our service for this, the first Sunday in Lent, by listening to some music in contemplation so that we can prepare ourselves for the service.
Lord, have mercy, Christ, have mercy.
I feel that I'm more focused having listened to that music. I'm so glad that you can join me today for worship. Here's an introductory prayer. God, who led the people of Israel through the wilderness to the promised land, help us to acknowledge your presence with us, even though we may feel that we too are traveling through a wilderness. And enable us to remain faithful despite our present challenges. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Grace and peace be with you and keep you in the love of Christ. Father of glory, holy and eternal, look upon us now in power and mercy. May your strength overcome our weakness, your radiance transform our blindness, and your spirit draw us to that love shown and offered to us by your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. We're going to use the prayer with the washing of our hands as a prayer of confession this morning. Let us pray. I wash my hands, but you, Lord, cleanse me from within. Make me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. I wash my hands, but you, Lord, cleanse me from within. Almighty God, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in eternal life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. So now we have the collect for today, the first Sunday of Lent. Let us pray. Almighty God, whose Son Jesus Christ fasted 40 days in the wilderness and was tempted as we are, yet without sin, give us grace to discipline ourselves in obedience to your Spirit, and as you know our weakness, so may we know your power to save, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And our reading is from the beginning of St. Mark's Gospel. Listen to the Gospel of Christ according to St. Mark. Glory to you, O Lord. In those days, Jesus came from Nazareth of Galilee and was baptized by John in the Jordan. And just as he was coming up out of the water, he saw the heavens torn apart and the Spirit descending like a dove on him. And a voice came from heaven, "You are my Son, the Beloved. With you I am well pleased." And the Spirit immediately drove him out into the wilderness. He was in the wilderness 40 days, tempted by Satan. And he was with the wild beasts, and the angels waited on him. Now, after John was arrested, Jesus came to Galilee, proclaiming the good news of God and saying, "The time is fulfilled, and the kingdom of God has come near. Repent and believe in the good news." This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. So now we come to the time for our sermon. May the words of my mouth and the thoughts of our hearts be always acceptable to you, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. Words that we heard from the Gospel of Mark. The Spirit immediately drove him out into the wilderness. He was in the wilderness 40 days, tempted by Satan, and he was with the wild beasts, and the angels waited on him. Well, here we are at the beginning of Lent, and I feel in something of a dilemma. I wonder how many of you feel as though you've been in the wilderness for more than 40 days. During this pandemic, it has seemed like an extended time of Lent. We've given up so much. We've been isolated from family and friends. And so that's my dilemma. It seemed to me that it would be churlish to suggest that we should take on specific Lenten disciplines. Haven't we been disciplined enough? The idea of discipline or being disciplined really relates mostly to punishment, doesn't it? Being disciplined usually happens when a person needs reprimanding for something they've done, and they need an authority figure to get them back on track, on the right path. And usually this is done, sometimes with an act of force or a withholding of privileges. Surely that's not what Lenten discipline is all about. For a start, it's a self-discipline, not something that is imposed by others. But if we're going to keep a holy Lent, it should be something which is positive. What am I to say about how we should keep a holy Lent this year? Lent, as we know, is based on the 40 days Jesus spent in the wilderness. Notice that in Mark, how the Spirit immediately drives Jesus out into the wilderness, immediately after his baptism, immediately after hearing the words of affirmation from heaven. Driven out into the wilderness by the Spirit. But this is clearly not supposed to be something negative. Despite the fact that Jesus is tempted by the devil, despite the fact that he's in the wilderness with wild beasts, this was to be a formative time. Somehow, the wilderness was a place not of punishment, but paradoxically a place of growth. I say paradoxically because there probably wasn't much growing in the wilderness, but of course it was a place for personal growth. What am I to say about how we should keep a holy Lent this year? That's my dilemma. I'm tempted to say, we've been in the wilderness all year during this pandemic. Maybe we should just be kind to ourselves, not put ourselves under too much pressure, not put ourselves through any additional austerity. And for some, that will be very important. For some, just spending time in Lent, being kind to yourself will be all that is needed. You know yourselves and you know what you need. But maybe for others of us, we do need to really set aside time during Lent and to treat Lent as a special time in which we can have a time of growth. As I said, I was tempted to just say, let's just treat Lent as an ordinary time. And then on Shrove Tuesday, I woke up very early and heard prayer for today. It was led by Lucy Winkett, Reverend Lucy Winkett. And she said, maybe we should ask ourselves the following question. What do I use in my daily life to distract myself from the deeper realities of living? Wow, that really resonated with me. I use an awful lot of things to distract me. And she went on to say, do I have the courage to change? Now, for each person, the distractions will be different. But it would be a shame if we didn't use this time of Lent. It would be a shame if we didn't use this opportunity to delve into the deeper realities. I wonder if you have the courage to ask the questions that Lucy posed in her short item on Radio 4. Questions such as, what is the purpose and direction of my life? Do I have the courage to forgive not only others, but myself? The Gospel reading states that Jesus was in the wilderness for 40 days, and the angels waited on him. In opening ourselves up to the deep questions of life, we certainly become vulnerable. We feel vulnerable. It's far easier to find sources of distraction which prevent me delving into the deeper realities. But the wilderness experience can be very productive. We can grow through it. The reality of the wilderness for Jesus and for us is that we have to place ourselves in God's hands. Jesus needed to rely totally on God. By being in the wilderness, everything else was stripped away. He had to trust in God completely, and that is, of course, what he had to do throughout his life, even unto death. We too have to place ourselves in God's hands. The emptiness of the wilderness demands that we trust in God. The vulnerability we discover demands that we trust in God. And Mark mentions the angels because it is a reminder that Jesus is not abandoned despite all the challenges that he faces. Now, I know I've bored people senseless by the number of times I've mentioned my pilgrimage experiences, but I'm going to do it again. Some of you will have seen the display of items I took in my backpack for the month. Going on pilgrimage is a bit like a wilderness experience because you only have what you can carry on your back. And that, for me, was very little. Deciding what to take is a real challenge. And venturing out alone is a great way of affirming, I am going to trust in God. Jesus had angels ministering to him. And as I mentioned in one of my early YouTube addresses, I had angels ministering to me on my pilgrimage. My angels were the people I met who helped me so much. Lucy Winkett mentioned that we need courage to give up the distractions that prevent us from facing some deeper truths and questions about ourselves. Maybe we have that courage. Because maybe we realize that no challenge is too difficult for us to face. God is with us. God sent angels to minister to Jesus, and he sends angels to minister to us. And God will bring us through Lent, into the light of resurrection, which is our destiny. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Shall we say the baptismal creed together? Do you believe in God the Father, the Creator of all? I believe and trust in God the Father. Do you believe in his Son, Jesus Christ, the Saviour of the world? I believe and trust in God the Son. Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life? I believe and trust in God the Holy Spirit. This is the faith of the Church. This is our faith. We believe and trust in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. We now have our prayers of intercession.
Lord Jesus, look with compassion on all those whose minds are full of anxiety and bewilderment, and for whom every day is one of despair. We pray for those who are experiencing severe financial difficulty at this time, many elderly people and young families trying to exist on very limited incomes, and those people faced with losing their homes and those who have lost their jobs. We pray that you will turn their despair to hope and free them from fear and self-hatred. Whatever the future may bring them, may they know that you are the rock on whom they depend, and that your love will help to ease their burden. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord of life, giver of every good and perfect gift, who has made the light of your truth shine in all our hearts, make us walk as children of light in all goodness. And as we pray for all people who hold positions of authority, that they do not misuse their power to the detriment of those they are supposed to be helping. We pray for all the world's leaders and for our own leaders who are responsible for making decisions about our future. We pray that they will be given the insight and integrity to govern wisely according to your will, being fully aware of the true needs of the people. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We have in our hearts some people known only to ourselves, some known to our church, and some only through the news, who are in need of our prayers. May your healing touch support and strengthen them, and we pray that you will remove from them all that hurts, harms, and hinders. Even in the darkest moments, love gives hope. Love compels us to fight against coronavirus alongside our sisters and brothers living in poverty. Love compels us to stand together in prayer with our neighbors near and far. Love compels us to give and act as one. It must be clear that our futures are bound together more tightly than ever before. As we pray in our individual homes, around the nation and around the world, we are united as one family. So, let us pause and find a moment of peace as we lift up our hearts together in prayer. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Loving Father, bless our homes and our loved ones. Help us to be grateful for all the good things we enjoy. Keep us from grumbling and ill temper. Help us to be kind to one another, whatever color we are, whatever faith we hold. And through our combined faiths, make the world a better place for us all. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Finally, Lord, we say a prayer for all those who have carried on helping us all through this time of the virus pandemic. All doctors and nurses who tirelessly worked, even though they could have contracted the disease themselves. And could even die. For teachers and care home workers, for all those who have helped to save lives, particularly the elderly. Lord, we thank you for having such in our midst. Grant them the courage and strength to continue. So we say together, Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Shall we say together the Lord's Prayer? Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. So now we come to the announcements. We're continuing to have evening prayer on Zoom on Sundays and Wednesdays at 6:30. So if you want to join in that, then send us an email and we can give you the link. We're also having a Lent discussion, and that will be on Tuesday evenings on Zoom, the same Zoom link, but that's at 7:30 on Tuesdays. There are some people who can't access YouTube, so if you know of any, do let them know that our sermon is available with the phone link, and the number appears on your screen. For some people, this time of pandemic has been a very difficult time, and so we're able to give you information about a counselling service known as Affordable Talk, which is a counselling service provided in South Wales, and they specially offered it to our area in these parishes. So do contact them. The details are on your screen. Do contact them if you have any kind of need. And sometimes just sharing, just having a chat with somebody can make all the difference. So don't suffer alone. And so we come to the blessing. May God show us the path that we must take, and may we walk upon it. May God's will be done, not ours. May God help us to trust in his goodness so that we place our lives in his hands. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you always. Amen. We conclude our service with the final hymn.